There's a new font in town. Enter. What? That overused Google font? New? Made for Figma and used by countless others, Inter is definitely one of the most popular typefaces for UI design. So not very original, you might say, but still, the update to Inter 4.0 is worth being explored, bringing three exciting and crucial changes with them that make Inter look a bit less like Inter. But is this good? Hello and welcome, UI designers and typographers. I'm UI designer and typographer Oliver Schöndorfer, welcoming you to Pimp My Type. Rigid, robust, and restrained. This is what we know Inter for. It's like a contemporary Helvetica. Not exciting, but solid. But most of all, it is made for UI design. And I still remember when it was fresh in 2017, and I enjoyed using it with all of its clever stylistic alternates. It was just so much smoother in my UI designs, until everyone else used it. Now with that recent update to Inter 4.0, it got a slightly different flavor, and more versatile. Now it is worth being considered for more text-heavy applications and even large text. Let's see why. The biggest change of the three is that now true italics are included, making the typeface a bit friendlier and softer. Originally, Inter was equipped with a slant axis, which is more aligned with this aesthetics of the neo-grotesque sans-serif that Inter is. Just look at Helvetica or Univers. I think Adrian Frutiger would pronounce it Univers. Both have slant Both have slanted shapes, and this is not wrong, it's just different, not wrong. Now what does that mean for your text? While the slanted style is more subtle, the true italics stand out more when used in long reading text for emphasis. Compared to its predecessor, it brings an advantage, making Inter 4.0 suitable for serious long reading text, especially with that emphasis. Now with previous versions of Inter, there was a problem. It didn't work in large sizes. It soon looked dull, larger than 24 to 30 pixels. Now with that redesign, Rasmus Anderson addressed this issue by adding an optical sizing axis. And this makes me so excited, because it's the best thing. The larger Inter becomes, the shorter the X height gets. While the shapes get more closed and the spacing gets tighter, it's just much more refined for titles and headings. Just compare the same text here with previous Inter and version 4. So much more refined. So thanks to optical sizing, Inter 4.0 is now a fair choice for headings too. But what's an improvement for display sizes might not be ideal in smaller sizes. Inter 4.0 is tightly spaced compared to the previous version. Not dramatically, but you can sense it. So I just recommend you should increase the letter spacing below font sizes of 14 pixels. This also brings us to another problem when it comes to Google fonts, but more on that later. If you enjoyed this video so far, don't forget to hit that like button. Thank you. Also new with version 4 are some additional stylistic alternates, which can highlight that softer look established by the true italics. Like the shorter F and the shorter T, also that simpler U. These are meant for large text, and to me, they look somehow off. Not really sober and clean, not really soft and approachable, something strange in between. Especially these shorter lowercase F and T, they don't play together that well with the other characters. And this is where I appreciate that you can activate character variations individually to create your own version of it. So I would leave these shorter versions out. Now note that Inter 4.0 is not on Google Fonts. There you will find the previous version. And due to all these updates, I assume that it will not be simply updated either. With the slant axis being removed and especially the changed spacing because of the optical sizing that I mentioned before, it would result in many possible text shifts and reflows. And if you want the updated version now, you have to go to Rasmus Anderson's website, which is linked below. Overall, these are some drastic changes. What do you think of it? Will you use the new version? Tell me in the comments. For me, not everything got better, but most things improved. Inter 4.0 will work for large text and body text much better, but it still remains a UI typeface. And since it's so overused, I recommend combining it with something more interesting. Find some suggestions of font pairings in this video here or in the link below. There you can also subscribe to the Font Friday newsletter and get my font reviews weekly. Das ist schon langsam lächerlich, dass ich das so oft wieder aufnehme.